For my future?
Last 1,000 years, they've been in slavery to the Burman Burmese. This school here, it's taking the powers of evil that try to take people and crimp them and cram them into this mold. You are an IDP and you are nothing. You're not recognized by any nation. You are nothing. You are big zero. God's got to do something about that.
When I first came here, I never stay hostel like that, like our school. And I don't know how to use the toilet or... I wake up at 5:30. If I have a test, I wake up at like 2 or 3 o'clock. I need to try the best. I don't want to fail.
I come from Mela Cap, Refugee Cap.
Who are you?
I'm a Korean people.
Whoa, yes, yes, yes.
One year, maybe when I come here, it's Halloween. I cannot say.
Hello, teacher. How are you?
Teacher, teach me. My teacher, teach me. Teacher Mandy.
I want to can speak many languages. Maybe if I can speak many languages, and when I go somewhere, if I hear somebody talk about me, and if I know it, I will answer them.
And here is the far outside our school. This is a very beautiful place.
My name is David. I come from Korean state in Burma. I come to save my life.
When I first came here, and we have pictures that show like a before and after, we took pictures of each of the children. On their faces is fear, uncertainty. They didn't know what was going to happen. They had been pulled around by life. Out of the jungles, different ones, over to Mela Camp, from different things that their experiences have been at that time, but always uncertainty. What is the future? What am I going to do? How is this going to work out for me? Hundreds of times, literally, in different circumstances, meetings, walking down the hall, I would stop a child. I'd look them right in the eye, and I would say, I love you. I love you. Now, do you get that? And they would, this began to do something in those children's experiences in those first 3 months. We were planning to go to 3 villages over into Burma. We went over there, we took materials over with us, yellow t-shirts for all the children. We'd go into a village and then the families would come out of the jungle. I just come from everywhere because this was a chance to get some medicine and get some help. And these children would sit there waiting for their turn. And during that time, I had a little instrument called an omnichord, and I would play it, and these kids were just fascinated. It was battery operated, and they were just fascinated by this music. And I'd get permission from their folks, and they'd come over, and they would push down this button, and all of a sudden, this beautiful music would come out. They thought it was so cool. But it established a relationship with children, many children, in those 3 villages. And then I went home and I got a call. He says, Tad, I don't know how to say this, but we've just got word from the Karen command that every village that we had visited had been totally burnt down. Many of the women were raped, older people shot, but over the hillsides we found little yellow t-shirted children's bodies riddled by bullets. It was a defining moment in my life because I had established a love for these children, and now many of them, from it may have been hundreds of them, had been brutally killed 3 weeks before I had held some of those children in my arms. And way down deep in my experience, something happened.